Namaste students, I am Jevin Dr. Rajesh Mohammed Khan from Department of Food and Biotechnology, Faculty of Agriculture and Veterinary Science, Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University, Jaipur. Today I am going to discuss about the topic identification of blood of the blood smear. So in this experiment we are going to discuss about preparation of blood smear and the cells which are found in the blood smears. So first, what are the blood cells? In the blood cells which are found in the blood are known as the RBC, WBCs, and these RBC, WBCs and the platelets will be discussed in this lecture. What are their characteristics and how they can be identified? So for the preparation of the blood smear, what we need? We need blood lancet and a sterile glass slide, another slide for the preparation of the smear, and Leishman stain. You can also take the Geismar stain also. So first we take the blood samples by making some puncture using a sterile lancet. First we rub the surface of the finger by cotton and alcohol, then we puncture with lancet and we take one single drop of the blood from the slide. And using a clean slide, we make a small smear. Then we stain the smear with the Leishman stain, or we can also use the Geismar stain. After that, we air dry the slide and we observe the slide under the microscope. In the microscope, how we can identify our blood samples? So the first cell which is observed in the blood is the blood red blood cells. Red blood cells are the most numerous cell types in the blood, and they are 4.8 to 8.5 million RBCs per ml. The cells are modified structurally to carry oxygens. They do not have nucleus. The cells are biconcave disc, approximately 8 micrometer in the diameter, and the absence of the nucleus, cellular organelles allow internal space of the cells to available for oxygen carrying. And also the interior RBC also contains hemoglobin, which is a protein of the function primarily to carry out oxygen. Typical oxygen has approximately 280 million hemoglobin molecules. Why they are present in hemoglobin? 280 million is a very big amount. This is because the blood cells do not have any cellular organelles. So this is the reason that they have enough space. Now talk about the white blood cells. They are now also known as the leukocytes. So they are of different types, which are involved in the protection of the human against some pathogenic bacteria, fungus and viruses. White blood cells are much less numerous than the RBCs, with the RBC WBC ratio of approximately 700 to 1. WBC played an important role in protection of the body against the infection. WBCs are divided into main groups based on the cytoplasmic appearance. First one is agranular leukocytes and the granular leukocytes. Granular leukocytes, lymphocytes and monocytes have relatively clear cytoplasm, and the granular leukocytes such as the neutrophils, eosinophils and basophils, whose cytoplasm is treated with the granules. In agranular, there is not any kind of granules in the cytoplasm, but in the granulocytes, granules are filled in the cell, in the cytoplasm. Now we talk about the granular leukocytes. The first one is neutrophils. Neutrophils are the first abundant granulocytes and the most abundant of leukocytes. And then neutrophils comprise 60 to 70% of the WBC. They are approximately 10 to 12 micrometer in diameter and very fine. The nucleus has approximately 2 to 5 finely concentrated connected nucleus lobes that are rarely uniform in their size. The multiple lobes nucleus are highly stained. So this is the neutrophils. I will explain the neutrophils with also with diagram also. The second type of cell is eosinophils, which are also granulocytes. Eosinophils are only about 2 to 4% of the WBC, and they are similar in size to neutrophils. The 10 to 12, they are in the 10 to 12 micrometer in the diameter with red, orange, large uniform granules. They do not block their nucleus. The nucleus usually has two, but many have three connected nuclear lobes that tend to be more round and uniform than found in the neutrophils. The red, orange colored and more uniformly spaced lobes nucleus are the keys to identify. Means the red, orange color and more uniformly shaped lobed nucleus is used for the identification of the eosinophils. Next is the basophils. They are also granulocytes. They are least commonly played WBC, and they are only about 0.5 to 1% of all WBCs. Basophils are 8 to 10 micrometer in diameter with large white black round granules in the cytoplasm that block the bilobed nucleus. The dark granules are the most easily identified characteristic of the basophils. Means they are very dark granules. Basophils exist in capillary and enter tissue fluids. The next is agranular. We are going to discuss about agranular leukocytes. So the first is lymphocytes. Lymphocytes make up 20 to 25% of all WBCs. These cells vary in size with a small lymphocytes about 6 to 9 micrometer, and the large may be 10 to 14 micrometer in that diameter. The nucleus stays dark and is round or highly identified with the cytoplasm appearing as a rim around the nucleus. So in the nucleus there is a rim-like structure. The round uniform nucleus and the small amount of cytoplasm surrounding it are the best identifying characteristic of the these lymphocytes. So lymphocytes are involved in specific immune response against some antigen antibody complex. Monocytes are the next, which have important role in the phagocytosis process. We have learned many things about monocytes. Monocytes comprise 3 to 8% of all WBCs, and they are the largest of WBCs. Means they are larger in size. They are in the 12 to 20 micrometer in the diameter. The nucleus is identified or kidney shaped. Okay, they are kidney shaped. They are not round, and they are surrounded by the foamy type like cytoplasm. Their size is the most easily identified characteristic. Monocytes are slow to respond to infection, but arrive in large numbers when stimulated. And large sizes the most characteristic. Next is the thrombocytes, which are also known as the platelets. Thrombocytes or platelets are numerous. Platelets are not WBCs. They are small cell fragments like WBC, RBC, and thrombocytes. There are three types of cells, and these vesicles have no nucleus. They often appear as spot or dirt between the RBCs. They have important role in the blood clotting and platelets function to plug small holes in the vessel and stop bleeding. And there are some enzymes which have important role in the stopping of the bleeding. So I must share the screen so that students must get better understand about the diagram of the these blood cells. So this is the neutrophils, and then in the neutrophils they are identified by the nucleus. The nucleus has 2 to 5 finely connected nuclear lobes. Okay, so these are the connected nuclear lobes. So by using these nuclear lobes, the nucleus can be identified easily. The next is the eosinophils. Eosinophils are also type of the cells. This is the diagram of the eosinophils, and they have 3 connected nuclear lobes. Okay, and that are round and uniform. Okay, but in the neutrophils they are not round. They are not round here. Okay, in the eosinophils the lobes are in the round structure, so they can be identified by these granules, large granules, red and orange granules. Okay, some red and large orange granules. So they are, this is the characteristic of the eosinophils. Now basophils. Basophils are larger, 8 to 10 micrometer in the diameter, and they are identified by their dark granules. Here we can find that there are many different granules in the basophils. Okay. So by these small granules, they can be easily identified. Now, lymphocytes. How the lymphocytes are identified? This is the lymphocytes. Here we can identify the lymphocytes very carefully, very easily, because these lymphocytes have a clear nucleus, clear round nucleus. Okay, so by these characteristic, by this nucleus, we can easily identify the lymphocytes. It is the characteristic of the lymphocyte that they have a clear round large nucleus. Now monocytes are identified by their larger size, and they have a kidney shaped nucleus. The nucleus is larger and it is kidney shaped. This another thing is that the cytoplasm is like foam. It is foamy like structure which have provided a support for the phagocytosis. So by these characters, the monocytes are easily identified. The next is the thrombocytes or the platelets. So these all are the platelets which are very high in number. Okay, these all are the platelets. There is a hollow like structure in the middle portion, which is the characteristic of these platelets, which have important role in the blood clotting. So I hope that students have been better understood that what is the blood smear cells and how we can identify them. So in this lecture, I discussed about different types of cells, how to stain the blood cells for their identification, and how the cells can be identified, what are their characteristics. So in this lecture, I discussed about the BBC and the platelets, and also I discussed about the WBC, RBC. WBC are granulocytes and agranulocytes, and different WBCs, which were granulocytes and agranulocytes, were discussed in this lecture. And I also explained the cells with diagram. And I hope that students are better understood about this lesson and what kind of questions can be asked. And the question which can arise from this lecture is that explain the identification of the blood cells and had the complete experiment on the identification of the blood cell from the blood smear. So I hope students can answer it very well. So my lecture is over here. Thank you very much.